Did you find on Wednesday night kind of the mad dogs and the character that you were looking for from your place?
Yes. Yes. Even the numbers, the stats, that for me are not fundamental, but sometimes they give us, they support our feelings, they support our ideas, or sometimes they are a contradiction to it, but in this case, I think is just a confirmation with the numbers, was the match where my team, the globality of the 10 players, run more, and run more with higher intensity too. We press the ball more, we put difficulties to the opponent, we were fast in our transitions, so we had that spirit, we had that mentality that brought our game to a good level, to a better level.
Is the problem though, when you've got players you haven't played before for a variety of reasons, they give you everything, have they got anything left for tomorrow?
No, there are special players with special characteristics, and you know, just to give you a couple of examples, Herrera, Rashford, they are the kind of players that even if their game was not phenomenal, that intensity, that desire, that passion, that sacrifice is always present. But I prefer to say that the team as a team had that mentality, and we have to try to transport to this game. I know that only 2 days, I know that is not easy. Fulham in the same situation as us, but probably the way they are coming to play or try to play will not demand as much from them that will demand from us. But no excuses. I sat here a few weeks ago speaking about the December month, and no defeats, that's a reality. Good fights, good spirit, but just one victory against Young Boys and 3 draws, and we need points. But Fulham is the same, they need points.
I mean, nobody should build things up into must win, but if you don't win this, what would that say about your squad, given Fulham at the bottom of the table have conceded more goals than everybody else? You just beat or drawn with Arsenal, had a good performance against Arsenal.
I want to be positive and think that we are going to win, but if we don't, give credit to the people that deserve credit, and the game is not going to be 11 against 0, it's going to be 11 against 11. Good players in the other side. I repeat that the position, the points, sometimes they don't say much about the real potential of the team. One of the two most important managers in the history of the Premier League, in my opinion. So they have their potential. They have their potential to come here tomorrow and to give us a very difficult match.
You've mentioned a lot that you felt last year was one of the greatest achievements you've ever had, getting that team to second. Could you explain what was deficient in the squad that you had last year that made you think that, which has obviously spilled over into this season?
I don't understand your question.
You talk a lot in press conferences and say last season finishing second with that squad was one of your greatest achievements.
Mm-hmm.
Some people might think, well, finishing second is not a great achievement. Could you explain why you think it was one of your greatest achievements?
Because
the deficiencies have spilled over into this.
You know, you can. I'm not speaking about our own situation, but you can finish 10th. I'm not saying us. I'm saying a team can finish 10th, and the manager feels like a champion. Correct?
Yeah.
You know, if you speak with David Wagner, Rafa Benitez, Claudio now, if you speak with them and you tell them you are going to finish 10th, they will feel like a champion. I made a fantastic job. I stayed in front of many teams with more potential than my team. And last season I finished 2nd, and I felt that we stay above teams with more potential than us. It's as simple as that.
Jose, obviously you had a number of issues to contend with the other night. Have you got any players back, obviously?
I don't know. Training session, 11 o'clock will give us some answers. Smalling, Jones, Martial, Bailly, of course, Lindelof and Alexis, we don't even speak about them. But we need answers, and for sure we are going to play with players not in the maximum of their potential, but players that will put themselves available for the team, like Smalling did in the last match, like Jones did against Southampton. Players in some difficulty that they give one step forward to try to help the team.
You spoke about Diogo's development after the match of the night, after a good game. I'm just wondering how you thought Fred was adapting to life in England and at Manchester United.
Fred?
Mm.
You know, step by step. Step by step. You have also other players in other clubs that they needed that time. And you have some of them that play even less than what Fred is... is playing. I think Fred, when the team is defensively stronger and doesn't need in midfield people that is more worried in giving some balance to the team than be involved in creation and attacking dynamics, the day we are stronger defensively, I think the horizons for Fred change completely.